Okay, so this review is going to be on the Gerber machete. Okay, this thing was only 3,000 something yen, so I guess about 30 bucks. And I compared it to the cold steel one that was there, and you know, price wise and quality wise, this one just beats it hands down. The actual blade, the teeth part of the blade on it, there as you can see, is very well sharpened. It came greased up, it was very nice. It's got a serrated edge on this side, so any of you guys that do any camping or survival training, you'll love this. And that feature the hole in the end. Also, like, probably mostly the fact that it's not a martial arts style machete, okay, because most of those are made for martial arts and not for survival training, okay. The fact that this has got a serrated edge on one side would probably fuck most of the guys that are trying to use it like a martial arts weapon, but I myself like to practice the same motions and cutting, not so much martial arts style, but in a combative manner of training. So that's, you know, it gives you some ideas. You can use this as a stabbing weapon if you needed to. Okay, a slicing weapon, and just a hacking weapon if you were to turn it around and start hacking and cause a lot of pain, especially if you hack and drag. Anyway, getting off the violent topics there. I believe that it doesn't go all the way down through the handle, the blade, okay? It's bolted in there, but it is well balanced. When you hold it, you just feel like cutting shit, you know? So, yeah, I mean, this grip here also is what they call a gator grip. Okay, and so if it's snowing, I'll just see if you can see that. Yeah, if it's snowing, or if it's wet, or if it's slippery, or if your hand's covered in blood because you've cut yourself, or it's been smashed, or you've been in a fight, or whatever, you know, you haven't got as much chance of dropping this because it actually sticks. Can you hear that? It actually sticks really, really well to your hand, even when it's sweaty and everything. So I've been using this a lot lately in my own training that I don't film, obviously. And yeah, I recommend this, especially, you know, it came with this sheath, like this holster. I like to call it a holster because it fits on your belt. It's got that there. And you know, even this thing's a bit solid, you know, so it's got this acrylic like thing on the inside of the the sheath there that stops it from being cut, you know, when you sheath it. It fits in really nice. Wraps around, it can go straight on your side there. So you know, for 30 bucks, I definitely recommend this weapon. I checked out just about all the machetes that they had there. The others were, you know, kukuri and the whatever else, you know, martial arts style ones, and that were just shit. I just looked at them and said, what the fuck is this, you know. You pay what you get, what you pay for, I guess, at the end of the day. But for 30 bucks, couldn't go wrong with something like this. So I definitely recommend it. Gerber, or however you want to say that, Gerber. Definitely look them up, and if you can find one, definitely you know, try that out if you're doing any sort of survival training. Okay, good luck.